youngest nigga reppin'. Oh my God, if I die, I'm a legend. Oh my God, if I die, I'm a legend.
What's going on, guys? AJ here, bringing you episode 34 of War Attacks. In this war, we're going up against the most rush clan I've ever seen in my entire Clash career. I don't know why I always have to clear my throat when I talk in the middle of these videos. I don't know why. I need to stop doing that so much. But look at their number two here. It's going to be attacked by Yuki. Look how bad their number two base is. I don't even know how we got matched up with these guys, but I'll show you their lineup. He's going to be sending in his king and queen here to take out the queen, take out the expo. He's going to be taking out one of the skeleton traps. Is not set to air, so it wouldn't have played too big a role in this attack, but going to be cleaning up some key defenses there. In comes his talent, balloons dropping down on the right side. That single target Inferno is going to do work on that Hound right there. In comes another Hound. Three Hounds out. Balloon's still doing work down there at the bottom. They need to get to that air defense. He's going to be dropped down his clan castle to help out on this bottom left side right here. Still has a Hound up, surprisingly, with those single target Infernos, but it's going to be going down, distracting that air defense just a little bit longer. The Balloons are going to be able to take out that single target Inferno. While that last Lava Hound is doing a great job distracting that air defense so the balloons can make it over there. Got some Lava Pups cleaning up those storages and are eventually take out that Town Hall. Drops down his last Rage spell. Still has a Poison spell if needed, but he's not going to. He's going to be able to easily 3-star this base, guys. Going to speed this clean up here. It's always a little bit slow with these balloons going around at the end, but the Lava Puffs do help out and speed this up just a little bit more. Town Hall is just about done, and then those Lava Puffs are going... Nope, the King's actually going to survive this raid. Let's jump into another attack. I think it was done by Danny on number 6. There's a live attack, but we missed that, so let's jump back up in... here. But as you can see, guys, there's a Town Hall 11 at number 17 mixed up in these Town Hall 9s. It's pretty bad. I think there was one a little bit lower around the 30s, but most of these guys are Town Hall 10 or 11. Not too many 9s. I don't know how there's this many rushed people in one clan at one time, but hey, guess it happens. This base is going to get absolutely wrecked with these Valks. I'm going to be sending a couple wizards here. Luckily, his wizard comes over and takes out them. It's gonna finish cleaning this up. Gonna be dropping down two golems to make a nice funnel to go straight in to the center. Hopefully, he can make that jump spell work. It's gonna be pinning down perfectly so that it goes straight into the center. No other apartments are gonna be affected by this. In comes his Valk, set off that one little bomb back there. His queen's in. I don't know. Oh, his king's already in too. He's gonna be dropping down a haste spell to get those Valks in there, drop down a rage so they can tackle everything super quick. Luckily, he did have his queen next to the Inferno Tower, so the Valks did perfect work in taking out both at once. So his queen's ability, she's at full health still. She's gonna be taking out that expo. Still plenty of Valks alive. I think only two die in this raid. It's pretty crazy. He does have his balloons coming here to clean up some of the side buildings. Perfectly planned attack, gonna be dropping down the latch, the blah, blah, blah. I can't even speak right now. The last haste spell. Queen still did not need to use her special ability. There's no more defenses left. I'm gonna speed this up. She's gonna hit that haste spell right at the last second. But I can see, guys, how many Valks are left right there. Let's see. Let me see if I can pause it real quick. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yes, there are 8 Valks left out of 10. That's how you know you had a pretty successful raid. That's another 3-star for our clan already. As you can see, a couple of 1-starred here and there. Let's see if we can find another good attack. I haven't watched all these yet. Looks like we got some more Valks being brought in. This Town Hall 10 does not have an Inferno Tower. Gonna be dropping down two golems here. Pretty widespread on is spread of wizards to clean up the outside building to create that nice funnel for the Valks to go straight into the middle. Because with Valks, if they go around the outside, they can clean up some percentage if you need it, but we need them to go into the center here. That queen is going to be distracted, and those wizards are going to gang up on her and surround her and take her out. In comes his king and queen. Pretty decent level king and queen there. In comes his Valks right there on those bombs. They're going to be breaking down that wall. Just kidding, guys. They're going to jump over that wall. King bashing on the wall on the outside. In comes his Hallriggers from the right side as that king gets distracted. Perfect timing on those hogs right there. That king is going to go out soon by the Valks. Offsets a giant bomb by that golem. Luckily, his hogs weren't over there taking out that Tesla at the time. It's going to have two heal spells left, and there are plenty of hogs left to clean up the rest of these defenses. Never mind, there might a couple of them died, or they're just grouped up really, really tight. But anyways, he's going to clean up the last of these defenses with these hogs. Still has his clean up, full health, has an extra poison spell there. I don't think this clan had clan castle troops at all in their clan castles. I don't know why. I guess that explains why they've only won one war. But we're going to speed this up because this is going to take a while. Sometimes you like having that extra 30 seconds. Sometimes it's a bit boring watching these attacks after all the defenses are gone. But that's going to be another 3-star for our clan. I'm pretty sure we're going to win this. I don't think there's a way we can lose this with this clan we're facing. But I'm going to end out of this. And that's going to be it for this episode of War Attacks. I hope you guys did enjoy. I'm going to try to start pushing back up so I can get that loot bonus. Get my Dark Elixir and everything back up. Because it's a bit hard to get that loot for me right now. I'm trying to use Barch, but it just ain't cutting it. So I'm going to go up, practice my attacks and everything. So that should be fun. I might have a couple videos out on that. But anyways, guys, I'll catch you later.